Hello and welcome back to An Old Man Watches, and today I'm going to be talking about the 2002 comedy horror film, with emphasis on the comedy, Fangs. And the film is set in a small college town in the rural US, where a pair of rather vapid female students are doing some work for one of their professors. Specifically, they're feeding his bats, a bizarrely convoluted process involving special, inaudible to the human ear, sounds. Later that same night, said professor gets eaten by his bats. And assigned to investigate the death are Detective Ali Parks, a transfer from the mean streets of LA, and veterinarian John Winslow, who is called in as the local animal control representative. Detective Parks is not best pleased to have some civilian messing up her investigation, and the two immediately have a snark fest at each other. They're totally going to make out later, of course. Now, just as in Jaws, and I guess if you call your movie Fangs, then stealing from Jaws is at least on brand, the civil authorities don't want alarm and panic to spread, and they lean heavily on Detective Parks to hush up the whole killer bats thing, lest it have an adverse effect on the town's annual Apple Blossom Festival. But of course, the bat attacks continue despite the attempted cover-up. Will killer bats spoil the town's festival? Will the corrupt officials get their just desserts? Will John Winslow's girl reporter daughter and her exceedingly dim boyfriend continually get themselves in danger? Will the main villain's identity be blindingly obvious? The answer, of course, is uniformly yes. Now, Fangs has a less than stellar reputation, as reflected by a 17% rating on Rotten Tomatoes and a 3.3 average rating on IMDb. So I had pretty low expectations of the film going in. And to be honest, in a lot of ways, the film lives down to those expectations. It's cheesy nonsense, and about the only way it could telegraph its plot points more obviously would be to hire Western Union to send you literal telegrams of them. And yet, despite all that, I had fun with this movie. So let's talk about why that is. And in particular, why I enjoyed it more than many other viewers of the film. And as I mentioned earlier, this is a comedy horror with the emphasis very much on the comedy. Now, I've got no hard evidence to back this hunch up, but I think that the main audience for comedy horror films is horror fans. It's a lot easier for me to imagine that horror fans would say, yeah, I'm okay with you adding a few laughs to a monster movie, than comedy fans saying, yeah, what my light entertainment needs is some killer critters. The thing is, horror fans have certain expectations that they want to be met, especially in what looks like a killer creature movie. Some scares, some tension, some gore. Fangs, however, has none of those. In fact, it's not even trying to do so. And it's not trying to be a horror spoof either. The horror elements, such as they are played pretty much straight. There's no riffing on horror tropes or nods to famous horror franchises. The film is actually more or less a situation comedy where the situation just happens to be somebody's using killer bats to commit murders. But the thing is, however good it may be as a sitcom, and I think it's all right at that actually, if my hypothesis is right, then most people watching it didn't come for the comedy. It's a bit like if you wanted pumpkin pie and you instead got a bear claw donut. Even if it's a pretty good donut, you're probably going to be disappointed. Now, all of the main characters in this film are played by actors who seem to be having fun in their roles, who pitch their performances well, but I have to give a special nod to Kirben Burnson's turn as sleazy property developer Carl Hart. Hart's initially introduced to the film as the primary driver behind the push to hush up the bat-related deaths, as the negative publicity would undermine his ability to woo investors. But it soon starts to look like he may be the common factor that links all the bat attacks together. Makes him a fairly significant role in the film, so it was important to get the casting right. And I have to say, if ever there was a man born to play a sleazy property developer, it's Kirben Burnson. He's made something of a career of playing charming jerks, and it serves him in good stead here. He gets the balance of oily schmooze just right. We, the audience, immediately know he's a shyster, but he's just charming enough that you can see why he'd be able to win over the unethical, greedy, or credulous. He's a fun character for the audience to dislike, and to hope see come to a sticky end. Now, I don't know what the actual budget was for Fangs, but given that it was made over 20 years ago for direct release to home video and DVD, it can't have been a particularly large one. And in those circumstances, I expected the bats to be a combination of shoddy practical effects and even shoddier CGI, the kind of obviously fake, weightless, barely textured balloon monsters that lurk in so many Sci-Fi Channel original movies. But credit where credit is due, though, Fangs does a pretty good job on the effects front. It's certainly not going to compete with blockbuster cinema releases, particularly given its age, but the killer bats look pretty good, move in a plausible manner, and even interact with real things in limited ways, such as grabbing onto somebody's hair. It's all very competently executed, particularly given the resources to hand. Now, the effects team were doubtless helped in this regard by some smart scene staging. Multiple scenes show the bats only in silhouette, such as when we view an attack through frosted windows. This, of course, vastly simplifies the effects work required, since all you have to show are shadows. Ultimately, Fangs is lightweight hokum, but it's competently executed within the rather niche cinematic genre it seems to be trying to occupy. Now, I'm not sure there's much of an audience for that niche, but apparently I'm in it. Next time, a change of pace as I discuss the quirky TV crime show Castle, or at least the first 7 seasons of it. I've not seen the 8th season, and I doubt I ever will. But that's next time. Until then, thanks for watching this video, and I hope you enjoyed it.